All right, I think we're streaming. Looks like we should be at least. And Twitch, come on, we're gonna update. Shazam. Okay, there we go. Looks like everything's all right. So, hello everyone, this is Chris Ingerson. It is August 25th, and this is the August 25th TechQuest Devstream. Well, that. Let's see. I'm gonna navigate to the scene that we're gonna be working in tonight before I forget about anything. So today we are going to be working a little bit more on the conversation stuff that we started last stream. But before we do that, we're gonna ease in, do some art real quick. So we're gonna do like a half and half sort of thing. I'm gonna do a ladder for the cabin interior because I'm slowly working on that still. Man, it's weird being split across like three fronts and everything. I have the conversation stuff on the stream. I have some of the art stuff for the cabin on the stream and off the stream, and then the secret thing I'm working on off the stream. So, I've already made a texture and a model for the ladder, and we're just going to warm up with some substance stuff today, and then we'll transition over to the conversation mechanics that we talked about last stream. So the ladder is, surprise, surprise, a very simple ladder. And the texture for it is actually pretty nice and easy. If we come in, you can see that it's just ladder, ladder, going vertically, and then ladder once across for our ladder steps. And I'm gonna go ahead and start by changing my value to be absolute 2K resolution so that we have nice high resolution working on everything. And then we'll get started with this. So, I figured it would be a good idea just to start with some art before we move over to the more interesting scripting stuff. Mostly because, you know, starts of the stream are pretty slow as people sort of trickle in to watch and or listen to my white noise inducing voice. So we're going to do with blend. And you know, we're not going to do anything too fancy with the ladder material. We're just going to do something pretty much the same thing we've done before, which is going to be you know, we have a mask here, a single texture that we're going to use to basically control color and metallic roughness and a whole bunch of other values from this one texture. So basically, all of this is substance, it's not outside textures, which is something that I always enjoy doing. All right, so let's go ahead and get started, get sort of the lay of the land going here. Normal combine for our last one. All right. And of course, we're going to expose this real quick. New, do normal format. All right. Let's just drag that in, copy this over, pull this over here. All right. And then, of course, we have to combine all of this stuff and merge everything in and make it all nice and neat. This absolute value 16 because that's the fastest speed and resolution size that we can get to. Let's drop this in, plug everything in, connect it. We're gonna make these white solid by default. And of course, we need to make sure that this is relative to parent and not set to be relative to input. And we'll do another blend down here. Move this down to here. Let's copy this, paste. Paste it down here again. And these ones are going to be the exact opposite. They're going to be solid black because we don't want it to be metallic by default. It's going to be wood by default. And let's plug things in again. Plug this in over here. Nice and simple. Uniform color. So while I'm doing this, I've thought up some more stuff with the conversation. Mechanics. I'm still trying to figure out how in depth I want to go. I do not think that I'm going to go with sequential conversation is I guess what I would call it. So you'll never be able. It's not like a dialogue wheel or anything like that, obviously. But the main reason I say that is because it's not going to be the sort of thing where you can ask about one thing and suddenly that opens up the possibility about asking about another thing. It's just going to be that you can ask about everything from the start. So if you know what to ask for, then you can ask it. Now, you know, that can be a good or a bad thing, since if it's the exact same thing every time, then people who've played the game before can just run through without getting crucial information and just do it because they know about it ahead of time, which is fine. You know, I am actually curious to see how people might speedrun the game, because I do want to open it up for that sort of thing. And obviously that's why I like to keep track of, you know, how many words people have used, how many sentences they've used, how many treasures they have, and all of that. Just because it's a nice thing to have. It's a nice stat to reward people with for playing the game, you know. You get to say, like, oh, look at this, but you could do better. Actually, it might be interesting to do something like Metroid, where if you beat it in under a certain amount of words or sentences, you get a reward. So, first things first, we're going to do a switch grayscale. This is going to be interesting. So we're going to go with, I'm sorry, not switch, it's going to be a multi-switch. Multi-switch grayscale, which is going to be... we're going to have two or three inputs. We're going to have one, an invert grayscale value, which will be right here, and then a solid uniform color value, which is going to be an absolute value of 16, and it's just going to be grayscale solid white. Or maybe it should be solid black, actually, now that I think about it. This should probably be relative to parent. And then that's just going to go right there. Why does that look so messed up? Oh, it's because there's no color. I was wondering why I couldn't see anything. And it's there. It's just very hard to see without color differentiation. So, yeah, the conversation mechanics, I do think that it's going to be something of a sort of weird case. But I do think that it will make sense over time, just how we're going to approach it. But yeah, no sequential conversation stuff. You're just going to be able to do everything from the beginning. I do need to figure out how to... I'm going to have to restructure the parser a little bit, which I talked about actually on the stream last time. And that won't be too bad, honestly. It'll be pretty easy to do that. And I know where to do it. I just have to put it basically between validating the verb and then the nouns and such. But that is something that needs to be done. Okay. So I'm going to... Let's navigate to this. And I'm going to grab... Let's see. Is it not going to be under bed? I think it's bed. We'll see. I'm going to open this up. And the reason for that is so that I can this thing, which is going to be pick, except it's completely going to screw up my, and of course I do it backwards. Give me a second here. Just doing these as the default colors, and I almost instantly regret doing this because it always messes with my tab layout, so I have to redo everything. So I think that's about where I usually keep it. Keep it wide enough that I can have two nodes over here visible at a time for each row, and then, you know, wide enough to interact with all this stuff. All right, so that makes it a lot easier to look at, because now I can visually see where everything is. There is not a lot of information on this, and I don't know if that's a good or a bad thing, honestly. I feel like I should pack it with more stuff. I don't just like having it be so simple. Ah, crap. Yep, I knew I forgot something. Well, I'll deal with it in a second. Fortunately, it's not that bad to change this stuff. Actually, I can deal with it right now, I guess. I need the foot of the ladder, which is the tops and the bottoms and such. So let's go ahead. I'm going to say top. Let's move this over to here. And then foot, which we can probably actually shrink this down to 72 pixels. Both of these guys, and let's just drag this down to here, and we're going to drag the foot and the top sort of up here, so they're their own little isolated area. They're not going to be interacting with anything else. All right, so now that we've made that change, let's go ahead. Dang it! Well, okay, fine, we'll just save it. I hate it when I do that. Open recent files ladder. I changed the SVG, not the actual Illustrator file. So yay! Just got to redo that stuff again. So we're gonna move this over here. Should be fine right about there. Maybe move it up a little bit. We'll try this again. And of course, it's now got all the default stuff set up, so none of it's what I want. 72. Let's just start typing top. Hit okay. Foot. Hit okay. Let's do negative 100 for our kerning. So everything's a little bit closer together. And that's all we need. I think we can drop this to right about there. So everything should now be set. Let's hit save. Close this. And then we're just going to save this out as an SVG again. And we're going to call it ladder underscore mask. Yes, yes, yes. That's all fine. Da-da-da-da. Let's come back here. Should see everything pop up. All nice and neat. So, you know, I do have some plans for the conversation stuff. I'm not entirely sure. Well, actually, that's not true. I have some idea of where I'm going to use them. But I am curious how I'm going to use them. Because, you know, there are multiple places that I could use them, and I don't want to just use them the same in every single place. Okay, this is where it gets somewhat interesting. We're going to... Well, this stuff's basically done. So we're probably going to actually do this. Let's see. Switch. It's going to be a multi-switch color, I think. Or yeah, it's going to be a multi-switch color. All right, still. Don't want it to mess up anything. Yep, that seems right. Okay. Because, you know, the most obvious thing is talking to people to get specific information. You know, for example, in the sewer level, you can ask the troll to move, which isn't actually getting information, but that is something that you can do. Let's move this down by one a little bit. I'm going to move these guys down by, I'm guessing two is probably enough. So you can ask people to move. You can say things to people to see if they'll react. You could answer riddles potentially, but it's really more about how to make it intuitive, because again, that is one of the big things about doing these sort of deals. Let's put this up here. Is you don't want to just have it in there for the sake of having it in there. There needs to be a reason, and it needs to be intuitive. And it needs to be used in preferably multiple places, because if you just do something once, then it almost always is just sort of wasted effort. So we're going to do levels here. I mean, I can already think of multiple places that would be good for the, let's see. That would be good to use conversation in. But we'll see how far we can get with it today. Because we might have some revelation in what might be interesting to use it with. Who knows? Let's zoom out a little bit. I believe we usually just sort of drag this down. No, we drag this down. Or better yet, we just drag this a little bit. Basically trying to drag it down enough to get rid of the black spots here. So everything's just a little bit better. All right, so that's wood. I think we're going to do this pretty quickly. I'm not too concerned. I'm just going to do one wood variant and one metal variant, and then we'll call it a day for the ladder. That way we can get right into... let's see, fractal sum base, I think. So we can get right into the conversation stuff. And for this, I'm not too worried about getting a normal map going. Should be fairly easy with that. The main question comes from this. How do I want to handle the normal? Well, I guess we can actually have a separate one for that. That shouldn't be too bad. All right, fine. So let's come over here. We're going to call this ladder for our labor or label. Author is of course me. Devstream.com, which reminds me that I need to update my website. Okay, so we're gonna add two inputs. One is going to be text. I don't know how to say this. Text bevel. No, it's not really quite bevel. Text raise, text plateau, text level. Ugh. I don't really like calling it that, but I don't really have a good thing. It's going to be a drop-down list. We're going to call it text level. It's going to be part of normal. Let's... Do I need to drag? Oh, there we go. Okay, so I need to be that wide at least. We're going to add two items. Get rid of this. All right. So this is going to be depressed, raised, and flat. All right. So we can just drop that. Then we're going to have lowercase normal type part of group normal. It'll be an integer instead of a slider drop down list. And again, we're just going to add two things. We're going to add one thing actually. Set this to two, and we're going to say wood. Metal, and I guess we could do 3, 4 flat, so there's like nothing. Let's put that up to 3, I guess, and we'll just do a normal color, which is flat. All right. This could potentially be... Well, we'll see what happens. Alright. So, this one is going to be controlled by text level. This one is going to be controlled by... Oh, dang it. I might have done it backwards. Normal type. Don't tell me I did. Oh, good. Whew. For a second, I did it on the wrong node. Alright, so we got all these things. Go ahead and take care of this while we're here. So true is going to be OpenGL. False is DirectX. Normal format, part of group normal. Normal. There we go. All right, so that's all that stuff, and I think we're pretty much good. Normal front. So all we got to do is just expose everything and then we should be good to go. So let's go ahead and put this here. That way we can move these guys up by one. Alright. So let's go ahead and we're going to add frame. Move this up and around. So we're probably going to actually have to move this up by one, which means that we're going to want to move these guys down by one. Work with me here. There we go. All right. And we're just going to add frame around this guy. Let's go ahead and start naming them. This is going to be masks. It's going to be red because of my color scheme that I like. This one's going to be color. It's going to be green. We're going to get these guys. And this is going to be blue. So fortunately don't have to do much there, but we're going to rename it, call it normal. Everything should be exposed on it. Add frame here. This is going to be rough. It's going to be purple. And then the last one is metallic, which is I believe cyan would be what I would describe that as. I'm not entirely sure. It's blue green. I kind of want to call it cyan, but I don't think that's. It looks more greenish blue than cyan. Anyway, so now we got to expose all of our colors. So we're going to expose this color. Oops. Expose this color. Call it color. Expose this color. Excuse me. Call it text color. Let's see. Expose this. Call it rough. All right. Expose this. Call it text rough. Expose this. Call it metallic. I almost got that right. Metallic and then text metallic. Text All right, so now everything should be exposed properly. Let's go ahead and set up the variable names real quick, and then we should be good to go. So set that to relative to parent. Come down here, open everything up. Call this base color, part of color. Call it text color, part of color. Move that up as well. This is base rough, part of rough. It's not going to be a color, it's going to be a slider. Clamp it. Then we're going to have text rough, part of rough. Again, slider. Clamped between 0 and 1. Base metallic. Part of metallic. Slider clamped. And the last one is text metallic. Part of metallic. And it is a slider. All right. So everything should be ready to go. Everything looks organized. And let's go ahead and export. Ladder should be fine. Export that out. And let's play with it, see what happens. All right. So we'll set it to be 1K. And just to mess with things, we're gonna have raised text, depressed text. I should have probably said inserted or insert. I don't know. Flat. Yep, that looks good. So let's go ahead and make it depressed again. Does not look like it's cropping out that much, though. That is kind of annoying. Oh well. Let's see. Normal format. That's OpenGL. Here's DirectX. And everything else I'm assuming is going to work. So. All right. Let's go ahead and export that. So turn off all everything but base color, make it a PNG, hit export, close this out, hit X. Come back here, we're gonna drag our stuff in. Let's see, ladder, 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 ladder base color. Copy it over. All right. So now we can create a new material in Maya. Create materials, Fong. We're gonna call this ladder mat. Again, reduce the specular color. Set our color to be a file. Call this ladder text. Let's pull this over with ladder base color. Hit open. All right. Oops. Object mode, assign existing material, ladder mat. All right. So now we just got to do some quick UV mapping. And we're just going to go ahead and highlight everything, do automatic layouts. Let's turn on background so you can see everything. I'm going to copy this over to a new UV set. Do a quick layout so that we get maximum light map coverage. Go back to map one. All right. And here is where things are going to be frustrating, I think. It might actually be more than frustrating. It might be downright infuriating now that I think about it. Just out of curiosity, I'm gonna mess with something real quick. So we're gonna split these guys. We're gonna say UV, cut UV edges. Come here, rotate this. Rotate it again. All right, let's scale it up real quick. Yup! That's what I was afraid would happen. It is not even. Hello, 18 Markwick. How are you doing? We're warming up with a little bit of art before we move on to the more programming-centric tasks of today. All right, so that doesn't work, which is unfortunate. Let's see if this will. See, because I think I made my ladder a little too square. So, to make it work properly, I think we're going to have to do something like this. Let's get our edges, grab these guys, and again, we're going to cut UV edges. Let's grab these guys, drag them out, or rotate them. Oh, come on, work with me here. Drag this over here. Scale up. So it's still not perfect, but it does work. And the problem is, dang it. Jeez. The problem is that if it works like that, it's not going to work for vertical, because the vertical ladder is way longer than the horizontal ladder. Oh, love art logistics. Ah, friggin' hell. So, a couple of ways that we can deal with this. The main way is just to redo the ladder part of, or the step part of the texture. Oh my god, why didn't I do that? Eh. I'm an idiot, that's why. Okay. Well, fortunately. Let's grab all this again. We're gonna do an automatic layout. Okay. So we're gonna save that. We're gonna come back here. We're going to open recent files, the AI file. We're going to change this. We're going to change this from ladder to step. That makes way more sense. So now we're going to save that again. Save it out as an SVG. Do mask. Save. Yes, I know. Come back here. Step is set up. I'd have to re-export it again. Yes, 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 I know. And then we'll have to export our source image again. Your girlfriend got released from the hospital today. Well, that's good. Congratulations. And as for when I'm planning on releasing the game, when it's done. I am really trying to get it done by June, I believe, of next year is my target. And I basically entered the content production phase, like where it's all content all the time. I don't really have too many new systems that I have to put in there. Like I have one right now that I'm messing with, but aside from that, you know, it's nothing too intense and it shouldn't really, it's basically just a grind to get content out now, to like make the level art, make the, or get the, levels built and just get everything playable, because you can play through the first two levels of the game. The next couple of levels are getting redone so that they're up to par. And then I have to, you know, actually finish the other levels. But again, fortunately, no new mechanics really. It's just content. So this is where it's going to be. I'm curious to see if it'll work. I'm going to cut this. These UV edges. Cut UV edges. But I'm a relentless perfectionist, which is not great sometimes. Because it does definitely increase dev time on things. Alright, so it's a little bit taller than I would prefer, but, you know, it's not terrible. that's the case. I think. How many hours would it be-ish? Oh. I guess optimistically that'd be 8 months. So let's say 8 months. I don't know. I'd say I'm gonna say 30 hours a week. I don't think I would. I'm not sure if I could say full time, like 40 hours a week or not, because I mean I work until 5 every day, except for weekends, and I do work a significant chunk of the weekend on this stuff. But it's hard to calculate actual hours. But I guess let's see. So that would be what 30 times. Let's see, f times 4. It's 120 times 8. Be 800, 960, roughly 1,000 man hours for one person. Although if I got other people to help me, it probably would be a much more manageable task. Hello, Garrett. Welcome to the stream. Doing some art to warm up before we get into programming again. All right, so yeah, that looks like it'll work. So I'm going to go ahead and do an auto layout again. And then we'll actually start repositioning everything. So first things first, I'm gonna grab these guys and I'm gonna flip this thing because I know it's upside down already. Okay, so we're gonna grab all this, and this is where it's gonna get kind of wonky. Let's see. I think all of this, move it over here. They're all the same size, I believe, as are these guys. So I should basically be able to highlight and push them all into one big thing. So let's highlight all of this. Da-da-da-da. Get it moved up. Probably should have moved them a little bit further away from each other so I wouldn't have this issue. Oh man, it's just a bunch of tiny dots. Vertices are not fun to select. Oh yes, I forgot. I was quite rude. How is everyone? Oh crap. I messed up for a second there. How is everyone doing today, by the way? Let's grab our secondary UVs again. Move these guys all the way over. Grab all this, slam it down, and slam it down. We know that A.T. Markwick has his girlfriend out of the hospital, so that's a good thing. Let's see. I'm gonna position this up, scale it. I'm gonna turn off the back face. Or the shading so that I can see what I'm doing. Crap, I missed some of them. Oh, nope, that would make sense. Dang it. Alright, so we're gonna leave this over there before I do anything, and I'm gonna slice these guys all off. Slowly work my way down. And there we go. UV, got UV edges. Last thing is we're just gonna grab all these faces, slide them over, and of course I somehow missed. Get all these guys. All right, so let's do our UVs. Grab these, move them both over. Grab these, move them both over. Grab these guys. Do. And rotate. Oh, not face. UV. Grab these. Move them down. Grab these. Move them down. Move these guys over. And over. There we are. All right, so that's all of the faces for the steps, at least. You're doing COW? Hashtag moo. Okay. Let's move this back down. Oh yeah. By the way, I'm probably gonna ask this on Twitter later, but does anyone know the usual hashtags that Interactive Fiction might use? Because that's, you know, despite the fact that TextQuest is a text adventure, I really haven't done much to reach out to the Interactive Fiction community. And I was thinking about that before the stream as I tweeted out. Like, I probably should start tweeting to people in the Interactive Fiction community. And I mean, I follow a couple of people that I know are involved, but I haven't done anything heavily, really. Which does seem like a mistake on my part. I really should do a better job at that. All right, so we're gonna grab these guys, move them all over. Move them over and over. Okay. Slam those. Slam those. Face. We're gonna turn on back shading again. I really hope this works out. Oh dear. It might not. Oh dear. No, it certainly did not. Hold on. A lot of space. I do not like that. Hold on. So I'm going to have to shrink it a little bit. Yeah, I'm not crazy about that. Freaking driving me nuts. Hold on. A little bit further up. I think we're... try moving this up or down a little bit. Okay, let's scale it down. All right, I think that's pretty close. It's not ideal, but eaten by a group. That's pretty good. It's cowmate. I see Danish is not your spoon language. No, it is not. I do not speak Danish. I mean, I figured that it was cow, but when you capitalize everything, it makes me want to say every letter individually. Or I guess just ask for more cowbell, which is a very dated reference. Huh. Ah, crud. I didn't think about that. Ah, crud. I also didn't think about that. Damn it. That's not right. Oh, hell. Jeez. Great. I gotta think. Ah, man. Why did I make this super hard on myself? Because these sides would not be the steps, now would they? They'd just be part of the ladder. Damn it. So close, but just not quite right. Well, I'm not going to worry about it too much. I'll fix it after the stream tonight. All right, so everything else is going to be pretty easy. Let's grab this. Because I have a similar issue with these things on the side. I don't know what to do with these. They're just kind of there. Because they're not the very top, so they don't need to go there. But at the same time, there are obviously not enough room to do much with them. All right, let's move this over here. Actually, the Eaten by a Gru hashtag makes me think of like the old Nintendo Power advertising where they ask, like, who are you? Rotate these guys. All right. And I guess, actually, these should probably be the other way, so they should be back to their original rotation. I think about it. All right. Grab these guys. They're gonna go to the feet. UVs. Move that over and grab this. And let's see. New wash. Okay then. A flurry of buns. Well, actually, that's not puns. That's wordplay, I guess, or it's a play on words. I mean, a pun is a play on words, but that's not necessarily a pun. All right, I'm going to rotate these guys. And then I guess I'm just going to leave these guys here for now, doing their own, like, thing, just chilling out. All right. So that's a decent-ish ladder. Not great, but, you know, it works. It'll be functional. So we're going to edit, delete history. All right, we're going to file, export selection. We're just going to call it ladder, export selection. All right, let's come down here, go to our models. Models, levels, overworld, cabin, and ladder. And before I forget, let's go ahead and get the substance in here too. So, overworld, cabin, ladder, 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 ladder.sbs. SBSAR, yeah. And let's go to scenes. That's weird. The icon that you posted doesn't show up on my second. Yeah. Yeah, I figured that it probably wouldn't be a good thing to look up on the stream. That would probably not turn out well. Let's turn you to 150. Hit apply. And real quick, we're going to pop over to the cabin and see what this looks like. Oh, cabin new is what I need, not cabin. Because the old cabin is terrible. He said as the blue chimney is clearly not ideal. All right, so let's drag this in. How are we looking today? That's about actually what I was hoping it would look like. Great. Let's drag it over here. We're also gonna make it light map static. Oh, you know what? Actually, no, we're not gonna do it for that. We're gonna make it nothing. Because we gotta do the whole like actor setup. Let's drag it over here, F. You know what I should have done if I was smart is I wouldn't have put the pivot right in the freaking center. I would have put it on the edge. Ah, well, these are the things that you don't think of when you're modeling. So let's rotate it 90 degrees. Whoa. Oh, that was the position. I was like, ah, that's not right. All right. So I'm guessing negative 4 point. Oh, I know. That's that. So negative 1.5? Maybe 1.75? Nope. It's going to be like 1.625, isn't it? Bet you that's what it's going to end up being. Okay, hold on. This is very awkward. All right, 9.5, I'm guessing. Yep. Aha, I was right. I think. Yeah, I was right enough. All right. So let's drag our substance on here real quick after we set everything up for it. No global illumination, no reflections. Let's just turn all this stuff off. It's fine. Go back to 1024 by 1024. We'll do nothing in cache on level load. Hit apply. And set our Niso filtering to 16 because I like to have very, very sharp textures. Ta-da! No, I didn't do the steps right, but it's fine for now. I don't know. People are super sensitive nowadays. So, you know, anything could set anyone off. Let's see. So all that's fine. And let's see. So next we're going to go ahead and do that. Move this up. Rename this model, call this a game object. We're going to call this cabin ladder. Now this is going to be light map static and I guess occlude static. And next, we're going to add some modules. So model module, collision module. We're going to add a box collider. I'm going to move this up. Move it up. All right, and last thing is, of course, to make this interactive. Yes, change children. And add a climbable object. All right, which does mean that I need to have my points, doesn't it? Interesting. Does it? Oh, because I have to add, well, look at that. Screw it. It's because I have to add the directions, that's right. Yeah, it's fine. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and add this, which is going to be our top. I'm going to duplicate that. It's going to be our bottom. Interesting. Oh, it's because I have global on. I was wondering about that. All right, so bottom is going to be, let's put it right here, I'd say. And top is going to be, let's move it up, up, and over. I'm going to put it over here. So we're going to say 0.5. Nah, we'll do a full 1. All right, that looks good to me. And last but not least, let's make it a prefab. Cabin ladder. All right. So that's all we're going to do in the cabin for today, because I'm still messing with the art stuff, namely volumetric lighting and all that. Have you seen Suicide Squad, Play No Man's Skies? I have not done any of those things. Suicide Squad looks pretty terrible. It looked pretty terrible before people started saying that it was kind of terrible. And No Man's Sky, I do not care for survival games at all. It is probably one of the, like, biggest sort of meh genres for me. I've never liked them. I didn't like DayZ. I tolerated Minecraft, but I would always get bored very quickly with it. I don't know, it's just, it's not a genre that I like. I like to take my time when I play games, but I don't like games that force you to be like cautious and sort of gather all of these resources or you'll die. Those types of games to me are just incredibly unfun. They are not a fun time for me. All right, so we're done with art for the day, at least for the stream. And I will mess around with the ladder stuff because there's clearly a lot of stuff that I need to work out with it. So we're going to move on to scripting. Let's go ahead and close this. And namely, we're going to do some character scripting. But I don't know. No Man's Sky, it was one of those. Better than Batman v Superman. Yeah, well, that's because pretty much anything is better than that movie. Again, I guess I can't really say because I haven't watched it because it didn't look that appealing. But, all right, let's close this stuff. Okay, so character, and then we're going to need parser. Drag you over here. All right. Let's see. Blah, 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 blah. We're going to go all the way down to, we're going to add a new step in our parser, which will be after set joint words, I believe, yep. After set multiple sentences, after set joint words, after validation and all of that. Let's see, right? Yes, I believe after validation, after set verb, after set determiner, after set quantity. And I guess after set direction? Maybe not. Maybe I should. This is interesting. Nope. I guess after set quantity. Nope, it should be before that because I have an indirect object only here. So, pretty much after set verb, I should probably do it. Actually, real quick, I'm going to look at my dictionary to see what determiners are doing. And no one's guy is so easy to cheat your way around the survival. Five hammers out of seven hammers. Yeah. I don't know. It's just, I don't know. So that Suicide Squad. No Man's Sky gave me basically not quite the same feeling that I had when Metroid Other M was announced. Because I remember way back in, like, what was that, 2010? I think 2010, 2011. When Metroid Other M was announced. Let's go to our design and then our dictionary. I remember everyone was super excited because it was like Team Ninja, you know, making a Metroid game. And all I could think when I heard that announcement was like, that's going to be a really bad game. And the same sort of thing happened with No Man's Sky where, you know, it was announced, everyone was talking about it, and I looked at it for like 5 seconds and I didn't think it was going to be a bad game, but I thought, you know, like, that's just not going to be a good game. And it seems like I was correct in that term. Although I guess it's your mileage may vary. It's basically if you expected, like if you didn't get into the hype culture of it, then it seems like you came out okay with that game. But a lot of people thought it was kind of disappointing. Where do you get all the icons? You have way more icons than I do. Actually, I think I have any icons because I don't do much with Twitch besides my own stream, which probably isn't good. I really should get into more stuff. Let's see, determiner. There we go. Every. Okay, so it's a quantity thing. I thought that was the case. Good. 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 So I should have all in here, right? Yep. All right. So it's just a number, then. So I scroll down here. We have all. Probably a couple down here. Single. Yep, that. This. Yep, okay. Alright. So, coming back to our parser, then yeah, even before determiner, it's basically as soon as we do the verb, then we want to do private static void validate conversation, I guess. Sentence. See, and this is, shit. It's not going to be as simple as adding a step, is it? Damn it. So we're going to do this, actually. We have to come all the way up here. And we have to add a new bool. That's going to be, explicit. So we have like explicit direct object, which means you're only or the direct object has been input. Am I even using this actually? Okay, good. I am. I think. Yes. Adjective only means that you only need an adjective. So if you're clarifying like between silver or rusty key, which key do you want? Indirect object only means that you have all the parts in the sentence that you need except for the indirect object. So we're going to add a new one, which is going to be private static bool. Is conversation equals false? The sentence should be treated as a conversation. So it's a little bit of slightly unique logic. And all it's really going to do is let us not freak out when there, like, a noun is used, but there is nothing of that name around. Really, they give you an icon for getting banned? That's pretty funny. So let's come down here. And actually, I need to do it in reset too. Receive input, reset parser. Here we go. All right. So we're going to say cached info is going to be. Ah, crud. See, and here's the thing. Nope. It is actually not going to go in parser. It's going to go into sentence. We're going to close this out. And we're going to go to sentence. Session sentence. Here we go. So we're going to have a bool is conversation equals false. All right, that's all we need. So we're going to come back here. Let's see here. Set joint words, check for obscenities, homages, validate sentence, and verb. Okay, so we're at validate conversation. This is where it's going to get somewhat strange. So we're going to see, check if the sentence should be considered a conversation. All right, so we're going to say if sentence.verb does not equal null and sentence dot verb is or dot verb type. Right. Fuck. So I could do this equals verb type dot speak. But the problem is that this verb type, I believe, is, it could be more than one verb type. It's a bit mask. So if you can see, if we go here, it's a bit mask, which means, hell, it might not equal speak, but it does contain it. But again, it might, no, that's going to be, no. I cannot think of a single word that simultaneously means speak and some other verb. I mean, outside of grossly exaggerated phrases. Man, no, I can't think of anything. So I'm just going to leave this as it is. I might run into a case later where I have to be a little bit more generic, but until I run into that case, I'm not going to worry about it. So we're going to say, if that's the case, then sentence dot is conversation is set to true. Set that to false by default. Yep. All right. All right. And then we're going to say set determiner sentence. So this is going to go from set determiner to validate conversation. Not terrible. I think that's all I'm really going to have to do. The trick now is that when we get into set direction, set DO adjectives, I do worry about this. I wonder why I have this commented out. For int I equals zero, sentence.count, sentence, prep. Perhaps because I don't need it here? Looks like I moved it up. Okay. So we'll get rid of that. I don't think I need it anymore. And that's because, right, if the preposition was not equal null, then that's fine. So let's see. Let's see, interacting keys. Maybe that's what I was trying to do. Affect only specific words. Let's see here. So we get all of our preposition types. Blah, blah, blah. We don't need to worry about. This is the thing that we need to worry about. Let's see. If the sentence is not an, so if the word after an adjective is not an adjective or a noun, and it is not adjective only, then we're supposed to say, like, you know, you used an adjective in a grammatically incorrect way. So it's like, move the red, eat. That makes no sense. But we probably want to say, and not sentence dot is conversation. Because if it is a conversation, then it gets sort of a special treatment. I say someone's, oh, you got a visitor? That's cool. Let's see. Sentence.conversation. I think that's fine. And then I'm going to have to do it again down here. So, and this. Okay. Shit. Do I validate the sentence after I set the verb or before it? Oh, dang it. I don't know if there's much I can do about this. I mean, I could move validate sentence below. Below my validate or set verb, but that wouldn't always be great. Well, stand your ground laws, I suppose. Although I don't know if that applies in Europe. That's definitely an American thing. But Let's see. So we're gonna set our do adjectives. That's all set up now, and it should behave as expected. Let's see. Where does it actually? This is curious. There should be something that says, I don't see a. There we go, right here. If the inventory finite direct object word equals null, and not sentence dot is conversation. All right. Man, this is like, ugh. This is really kind of tough to think about all of the cases that'll crop up. Which direct object would you like to cached verb? That's probably fine. Direct object with those adjectives not found. Let's see a blank direct object over here. Well, I mean, I assume. I don't know. Well, like I said, standard ground laws. That's what happens. Part of being a. Well, I was gonna say homeowner, but I mean, it's technically even people who rent and do all the other stuff have those laws, I think. But the drill noise. You got a drill noise going? Let's see. I think this is still fine somehow. It's kind of weird, but I think we're doing all right. Let's see. Come down here. Again, I'm gonna do the and not sentence.is conversation. And not sentence.is conversation. And not sentence.is conversation. And not sentence.is conversation. Okay. Let's see. I think I'm going to sneeze. All right. Excuse me. Let's see. Well, you know, the impenetrable doors of Europe. I've heard legends. Ah, man. Sorry, that was incredibly unfunny. Sneeze scrambled my brains, apparently. Let's see. Which indirect object would you like to cache verb? Ah, here we are. And not sentence. That is conversation. Okay. I think that this is good. I think this is good to go. So we're almost to 1800 lines on the parser. Hooray! Okay, we're gonna try this real quick. And if I'm not mistaken, I did add some updated dictionary stuff. Well, I mean, if they're outside again, isn't that good? Because wouldn't that mean that they're not in the house? I guess it depends. I would assume that would be better than not. Let's see, where was I? Crap. I lost my train of thought. Right, dictionary. I remember. Dictionary. And do you have a mechanical keyboard or a soft type keyboard? Because it really depends. Because my laptop's keys are pretty loud, actually. Let's see. Adventurer, blah, 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 blah. About. A-B-O. Preposition, verb type nothing, prep after, it points to the thing afterwards. Okay, good. So let's, All right, well, that's good. You survived one more night. Let's go ahead and maximize on play. I'm sure that we'll have some errors. But, so we're going to say talk to cube about... There's grass in there. Really? I don't have grass in there? Trees. Yay! I mean, it's not perfect. But, cool. So we got that working. Versus if we do trees. There's no verb in that sentence. Eat trees. I don't see a trees around here. Okay, good. Well, that seems to work. All right, well, I'm sure that's actually going to be a fun call. Well, good luck, though. Hopefully things turn out pretty well. Let's see. And... Right, I remember. Yeah, sorry. Kind of out of it, apparently, today. So, first thing that we need to do is we need to set up a fail state for something real quick, which is going to be, I believe, under... Ooh, you know what? I don't know. Game variables, maybe? Nope, crap. Probably global variables. Let's see if it's here. I don't know if it is or not. Seems like it would be. Let's see. Hold on. Nope. Great. Default fail. Okay, interactive object utility. Objects, verbs. Here we are. Ah, here we are. So, public const string default speak failure equals, so this is going to be what happens when you talk to an object that you can't actually talk to. And let's see. So I'm going to say, it cannot talk to you. It is a object name. I think that'll work. So let's try that, I guess. Output get default failure. Case verb type dot speak. Break out. I'm going to say, actually, we're not going to break, we're going to return default speak failure. Okay. So we're going to check this off real quick. So we're going to look up speak. I think by default I was leaving them to be, like just say the default thing. Text only. It's true. Right. That's not going to work, is it? Freaking hell. Alright, fine. Let me see. I guess I also need to add. Let's see. Let's go to verb type. I like these things to match up. Verb type utility. Let's see. Speak is right above insult. And right below perform. Right below move. Okay, so I guess it's going to go here. So public const string default output. Speak equals, I'm just gonna say hello. That should not really be the default case, but and again we're gonna do this case verb type dot speak return default speak output speak. All right. And the reason we added all that stuff is so that it can fail or succeed gracefully if we don't give it, you know, all the parameters that it needs necessarily. I probably will actually change that to the object name does not respond. All right. So now that that's all good, let's go ahead and select our game object here. Once it fully compiles, and of course, it's fine though. Speak output text only. You know, I don't remember where I say it should fail or not. Verbs, speak only output type. I guess it's right there, isn't it? Huh, I hide it. Weird. I don't know if I want that or not. I guess that's because it's really only used to determine stuff during parse time. It's not really used afterwards. All right. So let's go ahead and hit play. Now, this isn't going to turn out too well. But, we're going to say talk, say hello. Perfectly fine. So talk about. Ooh, this is going to be interesting. Trees. Good, 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 because the preposition is there. Yes! But talk trees won't work. Ooh. That could be problematic. Trees. Cube. Okay, hold on. Talk trees. Self. You can't do that. What would you like to, what would you like to talk? Is asking what would you like to talk to. That's problematic. For some reason, saying talk trees is ignoring, it's ignoring the cube, which makes sense. What it should do is it should use the noun trees. But, shit. Hold on. Okay. Damn it, that's not good. So we gotta go back to the parser. We only want to do this if... damn. If our direct object is not set, is not specified. Ah, dang it. That figures. So check commands, set verb, validate conversation, set determiner, set quantity, set direction, set do adjectives, which is the direct object adjectives. See, and this is why I was asking earlier. I don't remember really using this explicit DO. Find all references. It looks like, oh, here we go. We have it set to true. If indirect object only. Okay, so I really only use it in one place. Crap. Ah, dang it. Hold on. Oh dear. Oh dear. So I do have to handle this a little bit better. Because I think the problem is right here. Hold on, hold on. So I don't think I want this one right here. Let me get rid of it and see what happens. You should specify, like, talk about this thing instead of just saying, like, talk trees. This is not a caveman text parse search. It should be a little bit more nuanced. Let's see. So we're gonna say talk about trees. Hello. Talk trees. Yes. Okay. So I think we can say talk. Oh, hold on. Talk red. Rocket doodle goo. That's good. Talk about red. Good. Talk. Speak about. Do I have ask in there now? I still don't have ask in there. About blue. Talk speak, curious. Not speed. Talk speak. Good. But we still run into the problem of doing this. So talk tree. I don't have house. I have cabin. Tree cabin. Hold on. Talk about tree cabin. Oh, that's interesting. Curious, curious, curious. I guess. Wait, nope, that's only two still. Let me try one more. Talk about tree cabin wheat. Really? Doesn't seem right. I would have thought that the validating sentence thing would have caught it. Give me a second. Why isn't it catching it? Set determiner, validate conversation, validate verbs, validate sentence. If sentence.word goes noun, 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 blah, blah, blah. If nouns are greater than two, too many nouns. But it doesn't seem to be doing that. Interesting. That's probably not good. Let me try just typing a bunch of nouns. Tree cabin self. Okay, fine. Eat tree cabin self. Okay, hold on. Something's wrong. It shouldn't be getting to the I don't see a tree around here before it gets you before you get told like, hey, you have too many freaking nouns. Hold on. Oh. Oh no. Well, that would be why. Why was I, Jesus, why was I being so dumb? Wait, no, that's not right. Look, if I type verbs, it catches it, I think. Eat. Punch. Too many verbs in that sentence. First if, because this should iterate through each one. What the hell? Huh. Well, you gotta love it when I run into a weird issue like this. Am I doing? How is this for loop properly set up? It doesn't, should never. be outside of the loop, basically. Huh. Okay, so let's try this. Oh man. Let's see if that completely like fucks everything up. Why would I put it inside the for loop? Eat self. Okay. Eat punch. I did not understand that sentence. What the hell? Wait, hold on. Too many verbs. Why? Hold on. This is like super weird. Huh. Because this should be here. There was no verb in that sentence. There were too many nouns in the sentence, and there were not ver were no verbs in that sentence. Okay. Strange, so my validate sentence thing has just never been doing its job, basically? Because they would get reset every time. What the hell? How did I not notice that for so long? I must have safety checks built into the other functions that take care of that. Weird. Yeah, so that kind of explains things. Let's try this. So eat, punch. There are too many verbs in that sentence. Eat self. Auto-cannibalism isn't the answer. Eat and punch self. Auto-cannibalism isn't the answer. Stop hitting yourself. Okay. Trees cabin. Self. There were no verbs in that sentence. Okay. So now we should be able to do this. Talk about trees. Oh, this is going to be interesting. Cabin. Okay, so again, but instead of just two, we're gonna say spider. Interesting. It still works. But why? Why does it still work? I don't, huh? Because it's got three nouns. It should... But it should stop. Hold on, I'm going to try something else. Talk about tree and spider. I don't see a spider around here. That's problematic. I bet... Ah, hell. I bet what's happening is talk is the verb. So this is two sentences technically because and splits it up. So talk about tree becomes one sentence. And since about is before tree, it makes the tree an indirect object. There's no noun before about, which means that it just implicitly grabs the cube. However, spider, since it's a separate sentence due to the and, becomes the verb is talk and the spider is the subject. So, probably what we should do is have Any prepositions carry over too? Jeez, okay. Taking care of oversights. Still though, I mean, I am curious why the freaking validate sentence isn't working for for catching the nouns. It doesn't make sense. So we can move this up here. Weird. Weird, weird, weird. All right. Well, in any case, the set quantity, set direction, set DO adjectives. Here's the thing. Let's go to set verbs to show you what I mean. If verb.count equals zero, possible verbs equals zero, and cache verbs equal to null, no verb in that sentence. If verbs.count sentences, it must be up here when I split it into multiple sentences. Set joint words. Set multiple sentences. Here we go. So we have to set our verb here, which is what happens. Conjunctions, new sentences don't count. Set joint words if output sentences don't count, sentences validated. Output sentences I direct object don't count is equal to zero. We don't care about that. We want the verbs. Tut tut tut. Sentence has no sh subject. Sentence with a subject. Okay. Ah, crap. So I. Doesn't seem right. So we set our sentences. We basically split them up based on conjunctions. And it looks like the verb doesn't actually carry over. Instead, what would happen is that it would assign objects, but only direct objects. Okay. Crap. I'm gonna do a to-do here. To-do handle passing prepositions. Verbs in specific cases. Talk about trees spiders, for example. All right. Okay, well, that's interesting. So we're going to do, I think, one more thing before I call it a night on the stream. And that's going to be to set up a response from a character when you say something that they just don't recognize. So let's go to our character script. So we're going to have a public test talk. Default response, I guess. Doesn't seem right, but I guess actually, no. What would happen is it would just spit out if check verb. So here we would just do. This is still actually not that great. Zoom tag. So we actually need to set up. Function for this. Because right now we're just very, very simply doing everything. We're not really doing everything in accordance with the rest of our systems. Wonderful. 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 I guess we can just leave it at base.check verb. So I don't even need to do anything special. It should handle the default case anyway. Because basically what should happen is if you don't put in any specific keywords, then the default output for hello should come up, which in most cases will be something like, you know, so-and-so doesn't respond to you or whatever. Or the object name doesn't respond to you. Great. Freezes. And here's the issue is I need to say verb success. This. To override things. And before I do that, I want to test something, so I'm going to do item. Come on. Let me see him. Item selection, blah, 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 inventory items. Sure, that'll work. Go to definition. I don't remember if I put in like a success thing that I just call now. I should have an event that gets fired at the end of everything. I don't remember how I did it. On verb success, there we go. On verb success, this and then verb. So I'll put that there. Not the best solution ever, but you know it will work. And then if we look at our item again, I do also have like a crap ton of this stuff that needs to be set. Let me look at this character, verb success return. Let's see, we need to reset the parser, which we do. We need to output things, which we do. After. If space after and verb.destroy after. It's odd. Da-da-da-da-da. So I guess we do this. Not great. Don't need this. And we just gotta do using sleepyowl.common. Alright. Well, that should basically do everything that I want. I didn't really have to change much there. Yeah, really more just like expanded on the functionality of the parser tonight. Didn't really have to do much for the character system. There's still a lot of work that needs to be done, especially in the inspector stuff. But for the most part, it's not really that complicated, which is nice. Let's see. So I'll just test this real quick, and I think we're gonna call it a night after that. I'm a little tired, and the rest of the stuff that I need to do are kind of boring. So I'm gonna say talk. I'm gonna say hello. I'm gonna say talk about blue. Okay. Talk about red. And then talk about nose. It's just gonna give us our default. All right. See, I wonder if I should have a unique output for just saying talk versus saying talk about something and then it not recognizing it. Yeah, I'm gonna add that, and then we'll call it a night. So we would have public test talk default or unrecognized phrase equals new. Yeah, all that stuff. And then I guess we'll say if phrases.count are greater than 0, it's going to do this whole thing. How was it? Unrecognized phrase? Yeah, that's probably what I would like. So we're just going to change that real quick. That way you have a unique output for just saying talk, which would probably be something like the object name doesn't respond to you, versus talk about salmon, in which case it would say the blank has no idea what you're talking about, or doesn't seem to know what you're talking about, and talk about red, in which case it'd be like, oh yeah, this thing knows what you're talking about. Debug this, close all our verb stuff, we don't need it, we don't need our phrases, we just need an unrecognized phrase. The object name doesn't seem to understand. And it's not going to have any words in it, don't need to worry about it. Ah. All right. Talk about tree. Oh dear. It does both of them. Ah, excuse me. Return. Yeah. Alrighty then. Let that go. Ah. Try one more time. Talk about self. Oh man. Talk about self. Cube doesn't seem to understand. Good. Now if I just say talk. Wait. Ah, right. Okay, I see what I did. Perhaps I should say something like, instead of phrases.count, because that's always going to be true, I have to do something like if sentence dot sentence dot count is now, see, that's the thing. shite. No, there has to be. All right, I'm just going to say dot count is greater than 1. It's not ideal, but it should at least help. All right, let's try this one more time. I think we'll get it. Talk, hello, talk about trees. Talk about tree, the cube doesn't seem to understand. Talk red, it'll do. All right, so I think that's getting a much more predictable behavior out of it. It makes a lot more sense. And it also is a little bit more robust. But yeah, I do have some parser digging I think I need to make. Or I think I need to do. Alright, I think that's a good place to stop. You know, we got a ladder in, and we have some more progress on our conversation stuff. It's not quite done. It's probably about two-thirds, I'd say. Because I don't really need to go much further into detail. It's more about fleshing it out now. Because the mechanics themselves, I think, are pretty solid right now. It's more about making sure that they're integrated properly into the system and things can listen for them and values can be set properly. And the inspector needs to be set up. But yeah, I think that's a pretty good place to stop for the stream. Might do a dev stream this Saturday. Again, I've kind of started just doing the non-dev stream interesting stuff on Saturdays. Because that's when I get the largest chunk of time to do development. Because obviously during the week I have my job. And then Tuesdays and Thursdays doing this stream means that I can't really focus on that stuff. So keep an eye on the Twitter feed for Saturday's dev stream if it's going to go up or not. And yeah, I think that's a pretty good place to stop for the day. As always, thank you everyone for watching, and I will see you all next time.